concrete.
Probably the allure of the whole thing was that it seemed like normal, everyday people.
It made music serious again, you know, and, you know, without trying.
It was the flannel, you know. It was the grease in the hair. It was
the unkempt style.
That was great because it got rid of all those guys with the hairspray and the leotards.
People weren't sort of going on to MTV to be on MTV. MTV was sort of coming to the music.
Something was about to give.
Something had to give. The dam was gonna break.
And it did.
And then Kurt came in like, you know, like a phoenix, you know? Like, he cut them down like wheat before the sickle. Whoosh! You know, you are done. Nirvana to me was the most significant thing since the Beatles.
The Nirvana album came out and everybody went, yes! Rock and roll just needs a good kick in the ass every once in a while. You never know when it's gonna come.
Very powerful vision, very honest man behind it, you know, very talented man behind it. I wish I was like you,
easily amused. I'm Kurt Loder with an MTV News special report on a very sad day. Kurt Cobain, the leader of one of rock's most gifted and promising bands, Nirvana, is dead.
I loved him. He was amazing.
I thought the guy was brilliant, you know. It's a loss, and at the same time, it was probably inevitable that he did what he did, but he wrote some great stuff.
So sad, because imagine, I mean, maybe we wouldn't even have half of the music we have right now if he was still around, you know. Maybe he would be inspiring people to write great music.